Here's a segment from a recent Gun Talk Radio episode. You can listen to all the Gun Talk Radio podcast however you tune in, or check out guntalk.com for more. But one of the things that happens is it's all administrative. And right now we're looking at Joe Biden's nominee, his second nominee, to head up the ATF. The David Chipman nomination went down the tubes. And so now he has nominated Steve Dettelbach to be head of ATF. And in a very interesting move, a bunch of state attorneys general issued a letter opposing that. And one of those comes to us right now. Austin Knutson is the attorney general of the state of Montana. Austin, thanks for being here.
Happy to be here. Thanks for having me, Tom.
You bet. So, okay, why? Why did you and a bunch of other AGs send in this letter opposing Steve Dettelbach?
Well, because this is Chipman 2.0. We know that Mr. Dettelbach is a lot savvier politically than I think Mr. Chipman probably was. He's a lot more careful with his statements. He's not as flagrant, not as openly hostile to the Second Amendment as I think Chipman probably was. But that doesn't mean he's still not just as hostile. That just means he's a little more careful about it. When you look at his record, when you look at the endorsements he's had as a candidate for state attorney general when he ran back in 2018, you look at the groups that have campaigned for him, fundraised for him, this is not hard to see. This is just Chipman rehashed. Dettelbach is going to be a zealous anti-Second Amendment ATF director. And I mean, as the leader of this coalition, I felt this was an appropriate act for us to do.
So, I mean, and your mother used to say you're known by the friends you hang out with. In this case, you're known by who supports you. And Dettelbach is supported by Moms Demand Action and Everytown and Giffords and every anti-gun rights group that's out there has supported his nomination. And you think, okay, if they really like this guy, then I think it's pretty safe to say he's not going to be really good for the legitimate, responsible gun owner and also not going to be good for the firearms industry.
That's spot on. And, you know, the other thing about it is that he's got a Twitter account. We can see what he thinks when he's writing a lot of his anti-gun, anti-Second Amendment rhetoric on Twitter. This is not hard to see what this guy's going to be like. And I think it's absolutely critical that the Senate scuttle this nomination as well. This is going to be interesting. Gun owners rose up during Chipman. The administration heard it. I think, frankly, Chuck Schumer got very concerned during the Chipman nomination process that he had some vulnerable Democrats in the Senate that he did not want to put in danger by making them take a vote on Chipman. I think we can rise up and we can have the same sort of reaction here with Mr. Dettelbach.
When you say we can rise up, what are you actually calling for here?
I think gun owners need to make some noise, like we did with David Chipman. I mean, you need to contact your senators. You need to call the switchboard at the U.S. Senate and let them know this is not the kind of nominee that we support, that we're watching, that we're going to make senators who vote for this guy pay for it at the ballot box. That's what I'm talking about.
Okay, fair enough. Let me tack on to this thing because something else happened recently. And I know that, you know, wearing your lawyer hat, you paid a lot of attention to this. And it actually, I think, is going to impact the ATF a good bit. And that's the Supreme Court decision in the EPA case.
Huge decision. It's been a great few weeks for the U.S. Supreme Court. You know, gun owners everywhere should be thanking their lucky stars that we've got Justice Clarence Thomas on the U.S. Supreme Court.
Yes.
A couple of great decisions, of course, the New York Rifle and Pistol Club case. But the EPA ruling is one that I think is kind of getting overlooked. But for a state like Montana, the implications are huge. This was a great ruling. Basically, what the court said is that government agencies, absent specific congressional authorization, can't just promulgate these overarching, wide-sweeping rules. And that is definitely going to affect agencies like ATF, because ATF is one of the worst actors at this. They are not afraid to just go out and promulgate rules and basically create law out of thin air, especially in areas that Congress didn't give them the authority to do.
Well, case in point, I mean, the bump stock ruling is a case in point where you say, okay, there's, you know what? Congress spelled out what a machine gun is. That's in the law. You don't get to make up a law. And I want to make sure people understand, maybe you can explain this. When agencies like BLM, like ATF, like EPA, when they make a rule, it actually does, in fact, have the force of law, because there's often are civil, but also even criminal penalties attached to that.
That's exactly right, Tom. So we've got the Administrative Procedures Act. That's a congressional act that generally gives executive agencies, like you said, like the ATF, like the EPA, it gives them rulemaking authority. And the thought there was, okay, we Congress, we pass laws, but agencies, you need to create rules to implement those laws that we Congress pass.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that act has just absolutely been run rampant and trampled all over for years. And you see rogue agencies like the ATF, like as I said, they're one of the worst actors. But EPA is also bad, which is how we got this ruling. You see, depending on the administration and their political ideology of the day, they'll weaponize these agencies and they will just start creating rules that don't comport with congressional mandate. They don't comport with the power that Congress has given them. And you're right, they do have the force of law, and they seek to penalize people who aren't following these rules that they promulgate.
Yeah, I think we're going to find that this ruling with the EPA case is going to be used. We're going to start challenging a lot of the actions of ATF and other agencies. Because for years we've been saying, well, you're just making up law. And they basically said, yeah, so what? What are you going to do about it?
Right. No, that's exactly right. And you know, the bump stocks is just one of them. And that's another issue I've been very, very active in. Tom, I'm an open gun guy. I'm a very active shooter, reloader. Hunter, I personally don't have a lot of use for a bump stock. I think they're a good way to waste a lot of expensive ammunition right now. But that doesn't change the fact that that rule should scare every gun owner in the country. If the ATF can come in and declare a plastic accessory a machine gun, that is very dangerous and that is stunning. And that is why a ruling like this EPA ruling is so important. And I think you're right. I think we're going to start seeing a lot more lawsuits.
Absolutely. Austin Knudsen, thank you so much for being here. Let me ask you this. Can you just, when something pops up that you see that we ought to be talking about, give us a shout and let's get you back on, okay?
Love to do it. Yeah, big fan. Happy to be here, Tom. Long-time listener. So thanks
a lot.
Sure,
I appreciate it. I appreciate what you're doing for the folks in Montana and now, frankly, for the people of the United States with your actions there. Austin Knudsen, he is the Attorney General of the great state of Montana.